Senator Skinner, we have this $300 billion spending plan. Obviously, this is a framework that you and your colleagues passed in the legislature. Still negotiations going on right now with the governor. Before we sort of get into the reaction to it, why do you think this spending plan is good for Californians?
Well, first, I appreciate your Warriors blue. This is a great budget for Californians because it has the highest level of funding for our K through 12 schools ever. So the highest level per pupil. And we've also got increases for our higher education, our community colleges, our CSUs, and our UC system. And then we've got very significant funding to improve the infrastructure, our transportation infrastructure, transit, bridges, roads. So all of those make this a really great budget for Californians. In addition to that, we have a rebate plan, direct cash to Californians who are experiencing these really high costs, of inflationary costs of goods and gas and everything else.
All right, I want to talk about that more in a minute, but first I want to get you to react to the governor's response to this. So his office sent out a statement. This is from Governor Newsom's senior advisor to communications, Anthony York. He said, while today is an important step forward, meaning when the budget proposal was agreed upon and released, there is more work to be done. Governor Newsom would like to see more immediate direct relief to help millions more families with rising gas prices, groceries, rent prices. The governor's plan includes an additional $3.5 billion beyond what legislative leaders have proposed to help millions more people meet everyday costs. And it goes on to say, given the financial storm clouds on the horizon, a final budget must be fiscally responsible. The governor remains opposed to massive ongoing spending and wants a budget that pays down more of the state's long-term debts and puts more money into the state reserves. What do you say to that?
Well, we have put the highest amount in reserve that has ever happened. And we have multiple reserves. We have a rainy day fund. We have a safety net reserve. We have the schools, public schools fund reserve. And all of those are at the highest amount ever with this budget. So, you know, when we experience some revenue drops, we've got some money to carry us forward. And the way I think the legislature looks at it, certainly we could have a downturn. However, we have people with need right now. We still have many Californians. Well, look at our homeless problem, look at the housing problem, and we've put a lot of funding towards student housing, towards homeless programs, towards affordable housing. And you know, if we reach a point where we have a reduction in revenues, well, then certainly we'll have to cut back on those. But the need is so great now, the legislature, we feel like we should put that money out there now and get people off the street who are homeless, get people into affordable housing, and get students housed.
There hasn't been a lot of agreement from what leaders in the legislature, meaning the pro tem and the speaker and the assembly speaker and some moderate Democrats, and what the governor wants to do in terms of the rebate. It started out as a gas tax rebate, then it sort of morphed into an inflation, you know, helping Californians with the rising costs of everything. It seems like that's going to be a sticking point. Where do you think it should go?
Well, I'm very optimistic we're going to get agreement because the legislature and the governor completely agree we need to get money directly into the hands of Californians to help them with these high costs right now. So we're in total agreement there. It's just the method. And the governor proposed giving it to people by virtue of how many cars they own, so buy their car. But we know there's a lot of Californians who don't own cars. And there's some families that own only one car, but maybe there's six people in the household. So we designed our rebate program to pay it per person. So a six person household would get six times $200 versus just $400 for their car. So, you know, it's the main thing is both the governor and the legislature agree that we need to give people relief from these high costs, and it's just a method, and I'm sure we'll get to agreement on that. And the structure of the rebates that we've done give the money to 90% of Californians. If we have to get it to a few more, then we can work that out. We'll be able to do that. So, and I think that we're going to get agreement there. And then the other thing I would say is that as much as these great things I talked about, schools, housing, homelessness, so much of that is based on the very good budget that the governor presented us. We just, you know, enhanced a few things, but it's basically the great budget that the governor presented us in January and then May with a few embellishments from the legislature. And I think it's good for Californians. And I think that, you know, with some more discussion and some more talk, we'll get to a point of agreement.
What do you say to Californians who may be watching this and they're like, TikTok, you know, we're struggling right now. Every time we go to the grocery store, try to fill up our tanks, we're seeing, you know, higher and higher prices.
They're going to get a rebate. That is definite. And it's just a matter of, will it come to you based on your car ownership, or will it come to you based on the number of people in your household?